Greetings. Yet another reason to reject Islam. The paradise Islam offers is full of carnal sexual sin. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth. Whoa, that was over too quick! What? You mean it is not obvious? Okay, maybe I should slow down and back up. But before I do, this video is rated NC-17. I'm going to be blunt and honest and brutal about the evil, sinful crap Muhammad lusted for. You Mohammedans who blush at Ezekiel need to kiss mommy and daddy goodnight and go to bed. Have all the children left the room now? Reason number 8 why I will forever reject Islam is the following. The paradise that Islam offers is a reprobate sexual fantasy. Do I need to establish for you the teaching of the 72 virgins promised to martyrs? Often imitated, never duplicated. Everyone on earth who has heard of Muhammad has heard of his offer to his martyrs. But let's establish a little firmer foundation here. Hazrat Ali narrated that the Apostle of Allah said, "There is in paradise an open market wherein there will be no buying or selling, but will consist of men and women. When a man desires a beauty, at once he will have intercourse with them as desired." I don't know about you, but that makes my skin crawl. Did you Mohammedans know about Muhammad's promise of homosexual sex? Read it again, O Mohammedan. There is in paradise an open market. It will consist of men and women. When a man desires a beauty, at once he will have intercourse with them as desired. Muhammad says there are women and men to be had at this market in his hellish paradise. Muhammad does not say have sex with her, does he? He says with them. That includes both genders that this pagan reprobate fantasizes about having sex with. Really? Seriously? Okay, maybe that's one mistake by Muhammad. A fluke. A satanic verse. I mean, does it make any sense that a holy God would want to spend eternity as your party pimp? Think about it. Does the holy God of Abraham strike you as a repressed voyeur? Do you really think that for 4,000 years, God sent prophets condemning and forbidding sexual immorality, only to be a sick, twisted bastard who offers it to you as the carrot to get you to kill yourself for him? You think he denies you sex on earth just to make you so uncontrollably hard up you'll do anything to get laid forever? Really? Seriously? I warned you I'd be blunt. Islam is an insult to Almighty God.
No, 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 that is only the hadiths.
Only the hadiths. Right. I always love that dodge. Let's look at the Quran then. Quran 52:17. As to the righteous, they will be in gardens and in happiness, enjoying the bliss which their Lord hath bestowed on them, and their Lord shall deliver them from the chastisement of the fire. So get the context here. The righteous, they go to the garden, delivered from the fire of hell. Ayat 19. To them will be said, "Eat and drink ye with profit and health because of your good deeds." They will recline with ease upon couches arranged in ranks, and we shall wed them to maidens, the Arabic word is houris, with beautiful big and lustrous eyes. Dedad is not here to explain it to you, but he would teach it this way. Houris, 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 houris. These houris are nothing but eternal whores. Sounds close enough to pass the Dedad Award for scholastic effort. And in fact, if you look up what a houri is, a super slut sexual slave is not inaccurate. A Huri is a most beautiful young woman with a transparent body. The marrow of her bones is visible like the interior lines of pearls and rubies. She looks like red wine in a white glass. She is of white color and free from the routine physical disabilities of an ordinary woman, such as menstruation, menopause, urinal and offal discharge, childbearing, and the related pollution. The Huri is a girl of tender age, having large breasts, which are round-pointed, and, this is hilarious to me, not inclined to dangle. This is nothing more than the mind of a lustful man fantasizing about his sexual perversion. A female sex toy with no complications, no period, no children, no bodily functions, no responsibility. Really? Seriously? This is just another page out of a sci-fi fantasy porn novel. You Mohammedans are evil if you follow this crap. And God help you poor Mohammedan women, damned for eternity as sex slaves. Wait, no, you are not the Huris, right? You are not young enough, and your breasts dangle. My bad. That makes it all better. Right? Quran 44. As to the righteous, they will be in a position of security, among gardens and springs, dressed in fine silk and in rich brocade. They will face each other. Righteous, gardens, silk. Got it? So, and we shall join them to companions, Huris, with beautiful, big, and lustrous eyes. Still, the only things Allah will allow them to show in public through their paradise parkas, eternally covered in their bondage burqas. But that is only two examples from the Quran. And clearly I took that out of context, right? Right? This could be any garden sexual orgy with Huris. Quran 55. In them will be bashful virgins, neither man nor jinn will have touched before. Then which of the favors of the Lord will you deny? This doesn't make clear sense, the Quran being ambiguous and all. What does it mean to deny the favors of your Lord? Because it really comes across like Allah is buying your favor with his sexual super sluts. So I turned to the Musin Khan translation for clarification, wherein both of those maidens, restraining their glances upon their husbands, whom no man or jinn has opened their hymens with sexual intercourse before them. Then which of the blessings of the Lord will you both, jinns and men, deny? Now, don't ask me what jinns are doing in paradise enjoying the Huris. But Muhammad is stating women get raped by jinn as well in paradise. Read it again, O Muslima. Bashful virgins neither man nor jinn will have touched before. Why does Muhammad have to include genies in any of this anyway? Think about it. Think what a sick and twisted place this paradise Muhammad offers. I can go on. There are at least another dozen places where Muhammad documents his paradise of sexual orgies, with both women and men mentioned as sex slaves. And Islam calls Song of Solomon pornographic. But that hypocrisy and evil simply dodges the real problem. Islam's appeal is to man's sexual perversion. Islam does nothing to redeem man, nor can it. With 99 names, the Allah of Islam is still never called Redeemer. Chalk that up as more evidence Allah is not Yahweh. And that is why this is one more reason why I will forever reject Islam. There is no reason on earth you can use to excuse the perversion Muhammad is selling. And that is reason number 8, to reject Islam forever. And the interesting thing is, with 8 documented reasons to reject Islam, I have not had even one Mohammedan able to address any of the reasons. I think that is because they are truly irrefutable and utterly damning of Islam. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. May you want to be in the presence of Almighty God, the Holy God of Israel. Amen.